Championship now, it's going really well. Pole position today, what's the secret? You're making all the Poms look slow.
Well, I wouldn't say that. They're all fast guys, but you know, the INS Ducati's working really good. It's fast, and Dunlop tyres are working perfectly as well, and I've just got to hop on it and do the best I can, and you know, it's turned out great. We're both on the front row. It's going to be, I'd like to see some formation flying, but you know, we'll see how it goes.
The fact of the matter, you've been to Snetterton before, that obviously helps.
Yeah, we've been here last year, plus we come here last Friday instead of going to Donington, and it's turned out pretty good, and just got to, hopefully the rain's going to hang off and do the best we can.
All together now, timey kangaroo down, sport, timey kangaroo down, timey kangaroo down, sport, timey kangaroo down.
G'day, Paul.
G'day, Steve.
How's things going?
Not too bad, yeah.
You're leading the championship by some margin now with six races, six maximum points. How's it so easy?
Well, it's not that easy. You have to try every inch of the way.
Obviously, reliability, the Yamaha's working really well for you.
Yeah, we've had good reliability out of the new Yamaha. We've had a few problems in testing, but in the races, it's been a good thing.
But you like this circuit at Snetterton?
Yeah, it's not as technical as the places we've been to in the last few rounds. Alton was a bit more fun than here, but I enjoy everywhere I go.
How are the Aussies going to do in the Cricket World Cup?
Oh, I think it would have to be a Wallaby walkover, for sure.
And if all that's not enough, there's another very fast Aussie emerging.
Marty Craghill, reigning Australian champion, has come over to join the party, but he's finding life is not all barbecues and beer. His year started badly with a big crash at Brands, which left him limping for weeks. Everyone knows his potential, so when he's fully fit, watch out.
G'day, mate. If it gets warmer here at Snetterton, this could be the go. What do you reckon?
It could be, mate.
Things are going better for you, Marty. Injury problems are getting better or not?
Yeah, injuries are getting better. I'm getting used to the bike more and things are starting to go my way a little bit, so I'm looking forward to the rest of the season.
The success that Troy Bayliss has had over here, is that any influence on you coming over?
Yeah, definitely. I watched the video at the end of last year and seen that Troy was going really well, and I knew that I was competitive with Troy, so when the opportunity arose to come here, I thought I'd give it a go.
And the Cricket World Cup, who's going to win that?
The Aussies.
Sure?
Go Warnie.
Well, that might be the case with a bat and ball, but give a Pom a superbike and look out. But it's Bayliss leading, 1-1-3. Chris Walker, though, the Kawasaki kid in second. Hislop, his teammate, in fifth place. Emmett is knocked about. He crashed in practice. But there's a familiar face. World Superbike contender Troy Corser is here to spectate and help a boy in the 600s. But it's the front row we're talking about, Troy Bayliss. 0.8 of a second inside McKenzie's lap record on pole position. Chris Walker there fourth on the front row. Hislop leading the charge on row two with McKenzie right alongside. And the two Suzukis come next. Privateer Paul Young leads row three. 18 laps then ahead of them for round seven here at Snetterton. The race distance a little over 35 miles. The lights go green. The newly resurfaced track just 2 years ago here will offer a great deal of grip, a great deal of action. And it's number 32, Bayliss, diving into riches at the first turn. Chris Walker has gone with him. It looks like number four, John Reynolds, as they come up to see a corner. The back end of Bayliss's bike. Remember, it's cool here. The tyres will take at least a lap to get worn, to get grippy. And already a huge crash coming out of Sear. That was a very big one. It looked to me as though two bikes went down. We're with Sean Emmett moving alongside the number eight Suzuki of James Hayden. The fastest part of the circuit coming down towards the S's, but the Suzuki rider is brave. There is Chris Walker, race leader though Bayliss it is. Number two Walker up into second. Pops a wheelie on the Kawasaki as they go down into the bomb hole. The next right-hander will be the very, very fast, sweeping right-hander, 120 miles an hour of Coram Curve. Reynolds number four in second. It's Bayliss's teammate Hodgson on the back end of Reynolds, but race leader and championship leader Troy Bayliss as through at the chicane goes Hodgson past Reynolds. Steve.
Yeah, that was a good move from Hodgson there, but that's the accident we saw, and that's Dave Wood. He's crashed there, and we get a replay of this. It's Davey Wood going in. You see the bike out of control, and he's going in there, flings him into the air, and he incredibly just hits the top there of Shane Byrne on the Harris Suzuki, and they both go down. That was a big accident. Yellow flags waving there as the riders come through onto that main straight. So it's 32, Bayliss. He's converted that pole position there into the lead. Walker riding the wheels off the Kawasaki. It seems that the Kawasaki doesn't have the speed of the Ducatis here on this really, really fast circuit. But there they go, through the bomb hole. Not much runoff area. It's not a place you want to fall off. up into third gear to Coram Curve. Walker number two there, shadowing Bayliss as they come round Coram Curve in towards one of the slower corners, right the way down into Russell's, down into first gear as Bayliss brakes really hard, chucks it in there. First gear accelerating out of that corner. And we're on board here now with Sean Emmett, and that's McKenzie going through on the Yamaha. McKenzie dives through on the inside there and accelerates up over the start and finish straight.
McKenzie, of course, the lap record holder here. Reigning champion McKenzie's getting quicker all the time on the Yamaha, but the Ducatis here are over 6 miles an hour faster than number two Chris Walker's Kawasaki down the back straight. So that is why Chris Walker on the green bike is having to ride oh so hard. He's doing a great job. He's in second place between the two orange GSE Ducatis. Walker number two, Hodgson, the superior speed of the Italian booming V-twin going past, as up into second place goes first race winner at Brands Hatch. And after race one, of course, the championship leader, Neil Hodgson, who has come back to the UK after some seasons in World Superbike and Grand Prix, and he's had something of a rude awakening. But the 25-year-old from Burnley now trailing his teammate right in the wheel tracks of pole position man and race leader number 32, Troy Bayliss. We are riding with Sean Emmett as past goes privateer championship leader Paul Young on the Yamaha R7. That is a very quick motorcycle. Emmett, it's fair to say, the number 7 Ducati rider, not in your picture now, but the man who is a mobile camera for us, crashed very heavily on Friday in practice, and he's nursing a lot of bruises. His teammate, though, number 4, John Reynolds, not so for Reynolds. He is a winner with great potential here, John Reynolds, and this is the year he could do it again. Back with the privateers. Number 24, the privateer there, going very well indeed. That's Paul Jones from Swansea. So the Welshman's had a long run up here to Snetterton. The Privateer Championship alive and well, but 96 Paul Young on the Yamaha has seemingly dominated so far. But Steve, when we get into the more technical circuits later in the year, it could be a different story for everyone.
Yes, I think it certainly could, but the battle at the front really is between those two Ducatis, and there's Hodgson. He missed a gear. Neil Hodgson's missed a gear. That's allowed Reynolds to go through. Number 4 Ducati, Reynolds goes through into second place, and it really does seem to be a Ducati circuit. It's very, very fast. They're reaching speeds of over 170 miles an hour down that back straight. It's not that the Ducati has any more power than the inline four cylinders and that one of Chris Walker's, we can see in fourth place. It's just that they deliver the power much easier. The riders are able to get on the power a bit earlier, and it makes a difference. And we see a back marker there moving out the way as they all go charging past down the straight. Slipstream vitally important there, and Reynolds there really getting tucked in, and he's now weighing up Bayliss as they go in towards the S's now, down through the gears, right the way down into second gear as they flick it right, coming out of here, gingerly turning the power on as they go up towards the bomb hole in the dip here now, and Reynolds is looking threatening.
The dominance of the Ducatis, of course, is evident in World Superbike as well, and is the source of some concern for the organisers that the Ducatis do appear, and of course they're allowed to be 1,000cc, whereas the Japanese four-cylinder bikes are restricted to 750. Race leader Reynolds dives through, and he now leads. John Reynolds has done what he wanted to do, and that's get the chasers behind him. He's now got a clear track ahead of him, but look at Troy Bayliss on the inside. No. Reynolds held off on the brakes. Oh, enjoys the luxury of taking off a rip-off from his visor mid-turn. Now, that's not easy, because that big Ducati takes a bit of holding on to halfway around the bend. Never mind removing your left hand from the handlebar to tear off. But that cost me run a little bit wide, just a bit unsettled, Steve.
Yeah, that's confidence for you. You take the lead and then take one hand off to take your visor off. And there you see Bayliss having a look, and he does it. He gets the slipstream down the inside. Reynolds did run wide as they came onto the straight, and that corner is so important. You must get on the power early. Reynolds lost a little bit of time when he ran out there onto the old circuit, and that allowed Bayliss to go through. Now it's Hodgson's turn. You can see the Ducati bucking and weaving as they go down towards the bomb hole there, the big dip. The bomb hole, it used to be a World War II airfield here at Snetterton, but it's been converted into a very, very fast racetrack now. So let's see, can Bayliss keep that lead? Now we're on board with James Hayden, and that's our camera looking back at his teammate, number 33, Marty Craghill, the Australian. He's getting faster and faster at every race meeting. There shouldn't be much in these performance of these bikes. You can see the big air intakes on that Suzuki as it gallops up the air, charging down the straight.
Well, the Suzukis are quick, but it's a source of some concern for Paul Denning, the Suzuki team boss, that they are a bit off the pace, and we would have expected the fuel-injected Suzukis to be running with this Ducati trio at the front. It's Bayliss leading, number 4 Reynolds in second, number 25 Hodgson in third. Chris Walker, championship runner-up coming here to Snetterton. Is he going to go away from Snetterton? Further down the order, Look at these Ducatis. 1, 2, 3, and it's Reynolds holding off the challenge from Hodgson. No, not quite. It's a GSE 1-2 again into the S's, the orange bikes, and it's the Revy Racing Ducati of John Reynolds, number 4, pursuing hard in third. But there's a lot of experience under the head of John Reynolds. All the way through last season, he was dogged by injury. He is now fully fit. He has World Superbike machinery. Hayden, looking back at Marty Craghill. As Steve said, nothing between the performance of these bikes, and Craghill now shaking off those injuries. He is getting faster and faster. And I'm looking forward to the Australian Superbike champion when we get later in the season. He'll be fully fit. And I believe, Steve, he has all the capabilities of mixing it at the front because he beat Bayliss in previous outings in Australia.
Troy Bayliss is well aware, and we look at Hodgson now. He dives up the inside into Sears Corner. So now Hodgson takes the lead as they come onto the straight, but you're absolutely right, Barry. Troy Bayliss is well aware of the potential of Craghill. He's been faster than him in Australia. Once he gets fit, once they get the Suzuki sorted, he's going to be the man to keep our eyes on. But now it is Hodgson as they come down in. And there you see number 4, Reynolds goes through into second place. So Bayliss has gone from first to third in half a lap as they come through the S's there down towards the bomb hole.
Look at Reynolds and a brave move by Hodgson, the new race leader. So, winner of the first round of Brands Hatch leads here at Snetterton. He certainly has the tools to do the job in that Ducati. It is blisteringly fast, but similarly mounted, John Reynolds, number 4, knows his bike is every bit a match for the bikes either side of him, and he's going to go for it. Another wheelie as he hooks up a gear, coming out of Russell's onto the straight, past the pit wall, where the mechanics and the signalers are putting out the running order. John, you're in second place. Number 7, Sean Emmett, being passed now by number 96, privateer Paul Young on the Yamaha, who is having a whale of a time in this British Championship. He's making a habit of putting the factory boys behind him, just as he's done in Australia, but that demonstrates just how fast Emmett's Ducati is. Now, Emmett is injured. He's not comfortable on the turns. He's hurting all over. He's had a physiotherapist push and pull him about all the way through Friday night to get him supple, to get him mobile. But when you're carrying bruises like that, Steve, it's going to hurt.
It is going to hurt, and he's suffering. He's lost a little confidence with the front end of that bike, and he's got to build it back up. But meanwhile, now, number 4, John Reynolds, is passing. Number 30 there, it's Lee Humphreys, one of the back markers. He's got his way through there. Traffic can be a big problem, and it can slow you down considerably, but Reynolds has got through. But there, Hodgson hasn't, because he's been passed. Number 32, Bayliss, has got through into second spot. That has hurt Neil Hodgson in the traffic there. He hasn't fought his way really quickly through there.
Bayliss in second place, but it's Reynolds, number 4, who got the better of all those tail-enders, and that's a crucial point in the race when you can take advantage of the traffic. John Reynolds has done a superb job. Hayden, number 8, on the Suzuki. Craghill has now got ahead of Hayden, and Hayden is under some pressure from Neil McKenzie, who's getting faster all the time on the Yamaha. Let's see how it compares for straight top speed with the Suzuki, and it's quick! And no, Neil McKenzie just holding off a little bit on the brakes there, because Hayden is not unknown to throw it away occasionally when he's desperate. He had 2 big crashes at the World Superbike round at Donington a week previously, and he is a little bit secondhand. But through goes McKenzie into 7th place. Now, the best result for the Scot was Alton Park, 5th, and can he improve on that? I don't know, because Marty Craghill, number 33, is in 6th. McKenzie's in the hunt, but John Reynolds now making this race his own. He definitely got the better of the tail-enders, and he's looking oh-so-confident as he heads for the chequered flag along the pit wall. John Reynolds gets a maiden win in the 1999 British Superbike Championship. And it's been a little while coming, but no one is more pleased than JR. There's confirmation of that victory for Reynolds. Bayliss in second place, Hodgson, Walker, 4 rostrum so far, but he didn't manage a 5th here at Snetterton. McKenzie and Hayden both got the better of Marty Craghill.
You were heard to say before the race you needed a win.
Desperately, yeah. I mean, the chips have been down, and we really did want to win. We've had a hectic time, and now things are coming together. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
And how tough was that one?
They don't come much tougher, you know. It was ducking and diving all the way through the race. It was good fun.
Hard work racing against your teammates?
It was. We had, like,
you don't want to do anything too dirty, do you?
Yeah, and like we came across some lap riders, and you know, I got the better out of it. And apart from that, we were both on par, and it was just whoever was going to have a little bit of luck, and whoever wanted, you know, just turned out like that.
Formation flying,
yeah.
Eh?
All right.
Absolutely. Well done. Yeah. Thanks.
Great.
So So it's a Ducati 1-2-3 here at Snetterton, but John Reynolds getting the top spot on the rostrum, and he receives his trophy from 96 World Superbike champion Troy Corser, who is teammate to Carl Fogarty this year.
What do you think of the British Superbike Championship? It's pretty competitive.
Yeah, for sure. I was down in the last chicane there for that race, and you know, the boys are putting in hard. You know, the bikes are running really well, and it's good to see the Ducatis are running strong.
And I reckon some of these British boys are going to be in those World Championships soon.
Yeah, for sure. You know, it's, I know Troy Bayliss and Neil, you know, he's already been there and he's won a Superbike race, I think. So they're good enough riders to be out there, that's for sure.
Chris Walker with his fourth at Donington, I think, was a great result, and I'm sure he's keen to get over and do the World Championships.
Yeah, you know, Chris, he pushes the Kawasaki really hard, and like you said, Donington, he had a great result. You know, I had a bit of a race with him, and then he left me behind. So he's another young guy. He's got a good chance of getting up there.
Well, the privateers gave us some entertainment here at Snetterton, and reigning champion Phil Giles got the better of Paul Young, who was overheating. And Giles, third in the championship coming to Snetterton, his championship now live. You could be forgiven for thinking we've switched to touring car racing, but this is the course car making sure everything is clear for round eight. 18 laps again, and a wonderful start for Troy Bayliss, who popped a little wheelie on the Ducati, but he was overhauled. He snatched the front up. That lost him time. It's Chris Walker hitting the front on the Kawasaki as they go into Riches. Walker then leads, squirting along the short straight. It's almost a double apex right-hander here into Sear. Round the right-hander of Sear, holding it tight, not leaving any room. It was number 33, Craghill, who ran very wide on the Suzuki, but Craghill getting much, much better now. Walker leads on the Kawasaki. Bayliss, 32 in second. Hodgson in third. Fourth, Reynolds. Fifth, Hislop, number three. So it's Ducati. Ducati now going. No, it isn't. It's Ducati. Kawasaki, as nudging his Ducati ahead of Chris Walker, goes Troy Bayliss, the Australian, again. So Bayliss then, who leads the championship with a handsome set of points here, knows full well that he has a very busy pack snapping at the rear wheel of his Ducati. It's Chris Walker, desperate to get a win. He has not yet won this year, but he is probably, Steve, the most consistent rider out there.
He's finished every race this year, and he's finished very high up. He is very consistent. Last year he had a lot of tumbles and fell off a lot. He knows to win this championship, he's got to keep finishing, and here we see another graphic display of that Ducati as it charges past Chris Walker. Very demoralising for him here at Snetterton. A number of these competitors have had a lot of tyre troubles over the weekend. Such a fast circuit, using such high speeds. The Dunlop technicians have had to put nitrogen in the tyres to try and keep the temperatures down. Chris Walker was having some tyre problems in the first race. That's why he dropped back. I think they've changed a few things, and there he is, tucked into third place. And this is where the speeds are, 172 miles an hour before they break into the S's. You can see there, on board again with Sean Emmett. He's going a bit better. He goes past the Suzuki of Marty Craggle as they go into the S's, but he's running wide. He's very, very wide there, so that wasn't a good line. But back at the front now, number 32 still there, and it isn't, no, because Hodgson goes through. That was a mistake from Troy Bayliss. He ran wide. Now Hodgson's gone wide. Bayliss back underneath him as they go through Coram curves here. This is where Emmett fell off the other end. Back through goes Hodgson, 25. So he's back in front. That was three passes in about 200 yards. Hodgson there slides it into the S's, right down into first gear. Picks up the power on the 90-degree V-twin as it thunders out of the corner.
Worth a mention of Steve Hislop running strongly in fourth place, the number three Kawasaki, but it's Bayliss in second. Hodgson leads. Chris Walker in third place, number two. Reynolds just keeping a watching brief there in fifth. And I think Reynolds about to make a move as we look at Walker. A move on Steve Hislop, but is he going to get away with it? Look at Walker then. Bayliss, number 32. Interestingly, on the tyres, there are seven right-hand bends and two left-handers, as on one of the right-handers. Dows goes, number 15. That's Damian Bailey on the grass, up and well. And it never ceases to amaze me how the riders miraculously, thank goodness they do, walk away from those high-speed tumbles. Some of these corners, 120 miles an hour, unbelievably fast. And the right-handers, of course, taking their toll on the tyres. The left-handers, such as they are, and there are just two of them, are relatively slow bends. So it's the right-hand side of the tyre which takes all the stick. You can see the angle of lean. Bayliss's knee firmly on the tarmac, operating it just as a depth gauge, something of a stabiliser. They have a little pad which they have on their leathers to put down on the track so that they can feel. They actually push hard on the track and use it as a prop. Troy, position two, and there's absolutely nothing between the first two as away they go. It's Hodgson then, looking for another win here. He needs it because he's slipping back off the lead of the table. In fourth place when they came here, Hodgson, in the championship. on 76 points. He, of course, improved on that in round seven, but he wants another win. It's Bayliss in that team who's getting all the glory at the moment. A little look under the elbow from the Australian. Reynolds is up to third place past Walker. So again, it's a Ducati 1-2-3. Chris Walker, though, is going to fight back. He doesn't want to give this one up easily. It's a great race at the S's again. They'll come out of here, squirting now towards the right-hander of the bomb hole. Steve Parrish described earlier, down through the dip. Number 21, Phil Giles, privateer winner in round seven, is ahead of this man, Paul Young, the championship leader. So Phil Giles having a great time. The Yamaha seemingly still suffering those overheating problems, but it's Hodgson, number 25, leading Bayliss, and it's 1-2-3, just drawing away now, Steve, from Walker in fourth.
Colin Wright, the team manager from the GSE team, opted to come to Snetterton last week to test. He missed the World Superbike round at Donington Park, and it seems to be working because at the moment the two guys are formation flying right there. Reynolds is pushing hard. He beat them in the first race, but he's got his work on this time. Sean Emmett, number seven, Peel's in there. He's having a better ride. Right behind him, there is James Hayden on the Suzuki, and McKenzie coming through again. After a tardy start, McKenzie's coming up through the ranks now. That will move him into seventh place. So can he get past here? And they come down the straight. He's right in the slipstream, tucked in there very, very closely. Sean Emmett on the faster Ducati in front. McKenzie's on the inside as they come up towards the S's, but I don't think he's going to do it, and he doesn't. Bayliss is in front of Hodgson. It's turned around there at the front. Reynolds is still in third place, but Bayliss has passed Hodgson towards the end of this race, so keep an eye on what's going to happen here. I don't know if Hodgson made a mistake there, but Bayliss has definitely got through.
The time trap down the back straight did not lie. It told us the Ducatis were quicker than the Kawasaki. 6 miles an hour faster than Chris Walker's Kawasaki. They're ahead of the tailenders now, and Hodgson's run. Where's Reynolds? Hodgson has gone. Hodgson has gone out of the picture. He's got to collect himself. He ran wide. That dragged him well down the order. So now Chris Walker has gone up into third place. So a big mistake by the Burnley rider has put him down in fourth. We are looking now from the camera bike of Sean Emmett. Ahead of him, number 17 from Orpington, local man Dave Redgate. Let's see how the Ducati compares for speed. And that's how it compares for speed. It absolutely torpedoes past the privateer. And up the front, it's the Ducati, still of Troy Bayliss. But John Reynolds now means business. He is very close. Is it going to be a 1-2 here for Reynolds? Taking a look at Corum on the inside, John Reynolds. And if he were to pull that one off, that would be very brave indeed. Down towards the Russian chicane. As they come out of Corum, Reynolds looking right, looking left. This the scene of the McKenzie Hislop battle last season when they clashed into each other and allowed Reimer to take the win just as Troy Bayliss sees the checkered flag ahead of him. It's Bayliss who denies Reynolds the double, but never mind, John Reynolds. A good day's work. 1-2 will do for me, and championship leader Bayliss. Fist in the air, the body language says it all. Walker got third. Hodgson's mistake cost him dear on the run into the flag. Hislop fifth, McKenzie another seventh.
Far and near there for most of it. I wasn't keen to get past him, but you know, at the end I thought I can have a go, you know, I'm doing all right. But the INS Ducati was working perfectly, you know, it was fast, handling good. Dunlop tyres were quite sticky.
You were scaring us on the pit wall anyway, nearly hitting the pit boards.
Yeah, well, I was following Neil and that's where he was going, so I was right behind him.
No chance of catching Troy then?
Well, there was, but he had all the corners sort of marked. He learned his lesson in the first race, and he just basically needed to keep tight on the last three turns, and he did, so he just left me with nowhere to go with it.
Well, nowhere to go but second, but that's what it did to the championship. Bayliss now moving ahead, Walker still in second. John Reynolds, of course, will have improved, but he's got a lot to do because he's not yet in the top four. Privateer Paul Young, he is eighth. So Troy Bayliss, he'll need a Pantechnicon to take all this silverware back to Australia. And that's the Privateer Championship with Phil Giles now in second place because Davey Wood crashed. Giles Championship looking much, much brighter. Nottingham, Ashton, Smith and Harris bringing up the final four positions. There is Phil Giles, reigning champion. More silverware for him. Ducati firmly in control of the Manufacturers' Championship. Yamaha with a lot to do, but as we get into the more technical tracks, let's see what happens. The next one up is Donington.
And we'll have highlights.